Hello viewers, welcome to computer networking classes. So in previous video we had discussed about module 4, which is based on wireless and mobile networks. Now in this video we will be talking about multimedia networking. Talking about introduction, so here we will only talking about how we transmit audio and video files over the transmission medium. So what are the properties of video? So video can be transferred from one place to another at a rate ranging from 100 kbps to 3 mbps, so which are distinguished between low quality and high quality, and they can be compressed, so trade-off will be easy. And what is video exactly? So video will be the sequence of images with audio. Okay, so it is a sequence of images being displayed at a constant rate, like 24 or 30 images per second. So as I am talking about compressing, so there occurs two types of redundancies in compressing. One is called spatial and second is called temporal. So spatial redundancy means if a dot situated in one image and he is having a neighboring dot as of same color as it is. Okay, so it can determine its neighboring dot that he is having same color as mine. So this is called spatial redundancy. And if in one image there contains one dot and exactly at that location in another image or in next image it occurs, so it will be called as temporal redundancy. So temporal means between two images, and spatial means in one image. If there is a redundancy, then it is called as like that. Now higher the bit rate, higher will be the video quality. So it is quite easy to understand. If the bit rate will be higher, then the video quality will be higher. Now video can be compressed to support multiple versions. That's why there can be three versions of video at 300 kbps, 1 mbps and 3 mbps, from which user can choose. So user has options, like you see in YouTube there are several options for 144 kbps, 240 kbps and that like. So these are called options given to the user. Now similarly, video and video conference can be compressed on the fly to provide best video quality. So under video conference it can also be compressed. Now talking about properties of audio, so audio can be encoded on the basis of pulse code modulation technique, which you have studied in semester 4 in first module of data communication. Now analog data, analog signal is sampled at fixed rate. Okay, so these are combinations of some arbitrary numbers which are being estimated or rounded off to the powers of 2, like 256, and these are given some bits like 2 to the power 8. 2 to the power 8 is 256, so it can be represented on 8 bit. Okay, so if the decoded signal is not, so the decoded signal becomes degraded at the receiving point and it is not exactly like of original signal. To get a better output, we have to trade off between quality and bit rate. Now talking about types of multimedia network application. So there are three types, which we call as streaming stored audio video, conversational over voice, video over IP, and the third one is streaming live video audio video. So first one is where the videos are stored in servers, and second one is like that of Skype and WhatsApp or Facebook video calls. And third one is streaming or live telecast. So under streaming is stored audio video. So here the videos are pre-recorded as like a movie and TV shows. And the greatest thing is that the here videos can be get or requested on demand. And there are three features inside the streaming. Like first one is streaming means while we are playing the video, we can get later parts of the video at the same time. Second one will be the interactivity. So we can navigate or jump to another position in the same video. So if we can do that, then there will be more interactive session. And continuous playout means once playout begins, it should proceed in accordance of original timing. So continuity should be there in a video. Now, important performance measure for streaming stored audio video is average throughput. So for streaming, we need to give some average throughput to a network line. Okay. So to provide continuous playout, one has to maintain average throughput. And streaming stored audio video uses CDN rather than single data center to give better performance. So this CDN we will be talking in next video. So for now, conversational voice video over IP. So as I told you, Skype is an example of conversational voice video. It can be achieved by voice over internet, voice over IP, internet protocol. And requirements are for this application is timing considerations and delay specific. Okay, so here if the delay between two frames is greater than 400 milliseconds, then it will be frustrating for user or intolerable. Okay, and if there is delay between range from 150 to 400 milliseconds, then it will be acceptable, and below that range it will be non-perceivable to human listener. Now streaming live video or audio video. So it is similar to traditional broadcast over TV, and it allows user to receive live or radio and TV. It can be efficiently accomplished using IP multicasting. So technique used here is IP multicasting technology. Now as user is using or seeing live telecast, he can tolerate 10 seconds of delay from the point where he is starting the video. Okay. Now, streaming stored video. So it contains three type or three features from which streaming can be achieved. So first one is UDP streaming, HTTP streaming, then we call dash or adaptive HTTP streaming. So these two are majorly used in India. Like first one is streaming stored video. sorry. So one thing in all three features are common is that client buffering. Okay. So before starting the video will be consumed by the client application buffer. So in client application buffer, the starting blocks of video will be stored and then playout will begin. So this is called client buffering. Like in this scenario, there is a constant bitrate coming from the server to the client, and it will be stored in client application buffer. Now, as in real scenario, the rate cannot be constant as there are congestion happening inside the network. So for this feature, client buffering is done. Now, first one is UDP streaming. So in UDP streaming, here the server transmits the video at a rate that matches the client video. As like in UDP, there are no congestion avoidance and congestion control techniques. So the network data is pushed at that same rate where consumption rate is of video without the rate control restrictions of TCP. Okay, and it typically uses a small client side buffer as the passing is real-time transport protocol, which is called RTTP or a similar scheme. So it encapsulates according to this protocol. And another point here is, in addition to server client video stream, server also maintains a separate control connection over which client sends connection registration sessions, means feedback sessions. What are the drawbacks of UDP streaming is that here, due to unpredictable and varying amount of available bandwidth between servers and clients, constant rate UDP streaming can fail. Okay, so constant rate cannot be achieved in UDP streaming. And it as it is using real-time streaming protocol, its cost will be high. And many firewalls are restricting the UDP traffic, so it will not be helpful for us to stream the video. Now in HTTP streaming, which is the second part, here video is stored in HTTP server as ordinary file, and the URL is provided to each video. Now when user wants to see the video, he will request the video by giving HTTP GET request. And on client side, bytes are collected in client application buffer from the server. Once bytes stored reaches a certain number, video starts playing. As it is done over TCP connection, because of congestion control mechanism, this also follows sawtooth manner. Now, as it is using TCP connection, the drawback which is there in UDP streaming, that firewall will prevent it from receiving from the client, it will not be done here, okay, as it is using TCP connections. Now video can be prefetched in TCP or HTTP streaming. Okay, so for streaming stored video, client can attempt to download the video at a rate higher than consumption rate, thereby prefetching the video frames that have to be consumed in future. And this prefetched video is stored in client application buffer. Because of this prefetching feature, that HTTP streaming can limit the client application buffer to cure its loss. Okay, like what is done here is that web server will send the stored video, a copy of video will send to the TCP send buffer. From there, it will send over transmission via media to TCP receive buffer in client. Now from TCP receive buffer, it will go to client application buffer. From there, the videos is seen by user. Now analysis of video streaming is that in what time this buffer will be full. Okay, so if the fill rate is X and the depletion rate is R. So for filling, this X should be greater than R. And what is that rate for the you can say completely fully full of buffer? So it will be X minus R, coming minus going. Now early termination and repositioning the video means if the user is watching any video and he is navigating or jump off to any other location, and then he will watch the video till end, then the bytes which are consumed before repositioning gets wasted. So if the full video gets streamed, then it will be a huge loss for the server. So to get cure from this loss, the HTTP streaming can limit the buffer size, application buffer size. So useful if user wants to jump to any future position in a video. Now what is adaptive streaming and dash? So it is third video streaming type. In this, all clients receive the same encoding of the video. So in HTTP streaming, all clients receive same encoding video. Now despite the large variation in amount of bandwidth available to the client, both across different clients and also over time for the same client. So all the clients are getting the same encoding video. So this is the drawback in HTTP streaming. Now thus a new type of HTTP based streaming is developed named dynamic adaptive streaming over HTTP. Here video is encoded into several different versions. So like in YouTube, you can see that there are videos in 144, 240 kbps, then 720 kbps, 1080 kbps. So it will be following dynamic adaptive type of HTTP streaming. So it is using dash type. If bandwidth is high, client naturally selects chunks from a high rate of version, and it is low, it selects a low rate version. Okay, and client selects different chunks one at a time using HTTP GET request message. On one side, Dash allows clients to play video at different bitrate. On the other side, it allows a client to adapt to the available bandwidth. How much the bandwidth will be available, he can choose the same option as of available bandwidth. So if end-to-end bandwidth changes during the session. So in next video, we will be talking about content distribution networks. Till then, thank you.